The measurements that we have for this last layer of the Earth's atmosphere are very few, because it's difficult to take these measurements.
It's too high for planes, it's too high for balloons. You can launch a rocket, but then they come back down, so you only get a couple of minutes of data from one place. It's also too low down for most satellites. If you're going to spend €1 billion on a big ESA mission, you want it to last for a while. But if you're in that altitude, sort of 200 to 400 kilometres, you only last for a year or so before you drop out of the sky due to friction. It's a very difficult region to measure in sort of traditional ways.
So that's the UCLSat antenna for the ground station, and we'll be listening to beacon data, hoping it's alive.
One of the most interesting things that can happen in this upper layer of the atmosphere, the thermosphere, is when there's a solar flare, and that ionizes the upper layer of the atmosphere. So what gets ionized? How long does it last? How does that impact our radio transmissions? What about the chemistry of the upper atmosphere?
The lower thermosphere is a key part of the atmosphere because it communicates space weather down to our meteorological weather, but also it communicates energy from the meteorological region up into the upper atmosphere. And we don't understand how much of that energy is actually transferred up to the upper atmosphere. And we don't quite know how much energy comes from space weather influences from the sun. That's transferred down, that might be affecting our weather, our meteorological weather.
These are all things that QB50 can help to answer. You know, we're going to measure the composition, we're going to see how it changes in time, and how those changes propagate around the world in terms of space as well, with our samples spread out all around the upper atmosphere.
This extra data will give us an amazing amount of information and improve our way of predicting what the response of the Earth is to the sun's activities and to the activities of weather from down below.
So it could be a real game changer in terms of understanding chemistry in the upper atmosphere.